This conference will now be recorded.
Yes, good evening everyone. Previous session we discussed automata coding ESMA. Good evening. Automata fix coding questions, right? Now in this class also let us discuss some more coding questions, guys. Okay, yes, now focus on this one, guys. So now here I will directly display the code, guys. Okay, so relevant to some particular problem statement, directly go for corrections. Okay, so some problems, so for some problems we should write code, right? Okay, so those problems I will explain. Okay, so some problems, so directly you should go for correction now in today's class, guys. Okay, yes. It's good. So start reading from so this point, guys. Okay, so that is the function or method, so print pattern. Okay, so here some pattern code is there, guys. Okay, in that pattern code some corrections you need to make. Okay, so that so code should be compiled and successfully. Okay, yes, let us observe that code, guys. Okay, fine. Observe this sample input, ma, everyone. So sample input is 4. Okay, and next of all, So this is expected output, guys. Okay, in the first row, so you are observing so six ones, okay, and so in second row 5 twos, okay, in third row 4 threes, and in the last row 3 fours, okay. So you are observing in this format here, okay. This is nothing but inverted right angle triangle pattern only, okay, but you are observing so from six value, guys, okay. So we should start from six and we should end with so three values, okay. The last row we should end with the three values, guys. So this is the pattern. So for this some coding question is given, guys. Let's try to correct errors in this one, okay. No problem. So you can take some time, guys, okay. We're taking some time and evaluate correctly, okay. So here I will explain this code. First of all, observe, guys. So here some n value is possible, guys. So let us take so n value as 4, okay. And next of all, so I loop is taken, and next to that j loop. Observe this j loop, guys, everyone. So each and every time j loop is starting from so I value here, okay. And so it will compares up to this k position. So what is the k value? 6, guys, okay. Check. So whether it is correct or not, j value starts from 1, okay, and it will compares up to 6, okay. First time it will compare, it will for perform 6 comparisons, okay. By the next time, so j loop starts from so 2 value, right, because j value is initialized with I variable, okay. Means so each and every time j variable initializes with I variable value here, okay. In the second iteration, I variable value is 2, right, okay. So it will starts with so 2 now. So by that time also it will move to the so 6 iterations, okay. So but how many comparisons now? So for this one, so 6 comparisons, okay. So here 5, and so here by the next time, so 3 to 6, okay. So totally 4 comparisons. By the next time, so 4 to 6, okay. 3 comparisons afterwards. So j value starts from 5 to 6, right? So are you observing this now? Actually, if yes, very good. Here ID number 2 and 3, so given logic already. Printf percentile di Niharika is good, okay. Yes, so first thing is, so what you observed in the output, ma? In the output, you observed values like this, right? 1, 1, 1, 1, like this, okay? And next of all, you observed, so 2, 2, 2, 2, like this, right? Means here, which variable is so having value 1? So in the first iteration, that is in this iteration, okay? This iteration, so which variable is having 1? And in this variable, so in this iteration, which variable is having so 2i? That's very good, okay. So means here you can observe this error, guys, okay. This is the error, okay. Here one error is there, okay. So here instead of so j variable, we should print I variable, guys, okay. This is the first thing. And so one more student, 213 given logic here, okay. See, k variable value is fixed because of so k variable fixing here. So what happens, it will goes for comparing up to so last, guys, okay. That's very good. ID number 401. See here, this one, this statement is missing, okay. See, after completion of so for loop of j, we should induce this one, okay. So k minus minus, we should induce so this one, k minus minus. Now what happens, observe everyone, guys, I will explain now, okay. So now if I value is 1, okay, what happens, so j value starts from 1, guys, okay. So j value starts from 1 and it will compares up to so 6 here, okay. So totally 6 comparisons, okay. So totally 6 ones will be printed, okay. Next of all, so j variable so starts with the 2 value, okay. By that time, now observe, guys, so k variable is decremented, right? So here k variable value becomes 5, okay. So 5 means what happens, now it will perform so only 2, 3, 4, 5, okay. Two, three, four, five, right? 1 minute more. Yes, so do you observe one thing, my everyone? So it is starting from so 2, and so by the next time, so it is performing only 4 comparisons. Ma, do you observe this one? Ma, here few members suggested, so few changes, ma, okay? So in printf, we should print I, and so we should decrement k variable. So although we are making these two changes, still we are having some more error, ma, okay? So j is equals to I, 213, means if we print so j or I, it prints same, right, sir? Yes, ma. Now tell me correction, ma. Yes, you people told, so two corrections here, okay? Sir, one thing is we should print I variable value here. Another thing is we should so decrement k variable by 1. Although we did so these two things, so now observe, ma. Here I explained, right? Okay. First time it will execute so j variable gets values from 1 to 6. Okay. So on decrementing k variable by 1, so you'll get so k value like this, ma, 5. Okay. Next of all, what happens? So j variable repeats for only 4 times, ma, 2 to 5. 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. What change we should make? Okay. In order to so get so 5 iterations instead of 4. Do you observe this one? Afterwards, k value decremented by 4. So next of all, so j variable starts from 3. Okay. It will make only 4, 2 iterations. Okay. That's very good. Here few members suggested. So Prasanna, j is equals to 1. Very good. Very good. J is equals to 1. One more change is there, right? So here, ma, j is equals to I, you are observing, right? So if you take like this, so you will get so 6 ones, 4 twos, 2 threes like this, guys. Okay. So but we do not want this output, right? Okay. So that's why we should change this j variable. Okay. J variable value. So we should take so 1 here. Each and every time. So j variable should start from 1 only, okay? So j variable should start from so 1 only, guys, okay? Then you'll get so 5 iterations, okay? And next to that 4 iterations, all these, okay? So these are the changes we should make, guys, okay? So for this code, now I'll keep all these changes ma, observe. Here I variable, and so here ma, in this one j value we should take it as 1, okay? J value we should take 1, okay? And so next of all, so k variable we should decrement by 1, guys, okay? K minus minus after completion of so this one. We can remove k minus. Ma, if we remove k minus minus, just now only I discussed it, okay? Ma, so it will perform so this one, right? K minus minus, right? 1 minute. J is equals to 1 means so 1 less than or is equals to 6, 2 less than or is equals to 6, 3 less than or is equals to 6, 4 less than or is equals to 6, 5 less than or is equals to 6, 6 less than or is equals to 6, okay? So it will perform same comparisons, ma. We cannot remove this k minus minus. If you remove this one, so you get problem, okay? So we should keep that one. We should make these changes, guys, okay? So j variable is equals to 1. So we should print I variable value. And next to that, so k value we should decrement, guys. These three changes we should make, okay? Yes. Understood, my ID number 2B1. Once again, so you are doing these type of things. My ID number 2A0. See, once again, I have to execute. See, ma, here I already executed all these codes, and afterwards only I am displaying so in front of you. It won't work. Okay, for your sake, I will so type and execute your code. Okay, fine. So you are saying that so remove k minus 1 and so with for j is equals to I, so will work. You are asking this doubt, right? Abzoma, have a look at this one. I comma j comma k value 6, and next to that, so let us take n value 4. Okay. So now observe here. For I is equals to 1, I less than or is equals to n, I plus plus. For j is equals to I, j less than or is equals to say n, sorry, k, j plus plus. And next of all, so printing this one, percentile d I, okay, I will execute this code. All of you check it once more, okay? One minute, let me check. So let me scroll it more. Okay, so how it is working? So 4. One minute, let me check. Let me check. So with comments, I value, if it is 1, j value starts from 1, first time 6 comparisons, okay, 6 will prints. And so next of all, so this one, so j value, if it is starts with 2, okay, so then by the time 5 comparisons, j if start with 3, so 4 comparisons, j if starts with 4, so then, so 3 comparisons, okay. So j if starts with so this value 5, okay, let me check. Five less than or is equals to 6, 6 less than or is equals to 6, it is not printing these values. One minute, let me check. No, actually this one is working here. One minute, it is not required to change anything in this one, so we are getting correct output only. So this is the code actually. Listen, this is the output we should print, guys, okay? So for this one, actually it is printing there, okay? So just if we change, so printf value I, okay, without making any changes, so actually it is printing there. That is what I am checking here, okay? Yes, yes, ma. Just so we need to make so change regarding I variable only. I am checking that one. So 1 minute. Okay, actually here we didn't focus on this one, for loop of I. So this one will be repeated for 4 number of times only, right? Okay, fine. Okay, good. I will be, so this one will be repeated for 4 number of times only, right? So j will also get values from 1, 2, 3, 4 only, okay? Yes, ma. So actually we discussed some other thing, okay? So like this, j is equals to 1, and next to that, after completion of, so this one, okay? So we discussed this one, right? K minus minus, okay? So we made so three changes. Okay, I told these three changes: j is equals to 1, and next to that I variable and k minus minus. Okay, so with this one also, actually it will print ma. Okay, observe output ma. Observe output. With this one also, you'll get the same output ma. Okay, there is no problem in it, but actually so without changing this one, okay, so it is not required to take k variable minus minus, and next to that so it is not required to so change the j variable initialization also. Okay ma, good. So number of ways are there, okay, to take the same one. So but here for this one only one change is required. Okay, that's good. I didn't focus on this one actually, I variable loop. Okay ma, good. So that one also works and this one also works, guys. Okay, so k variable without so decrementing. So here in this way also it will works, guys, by taking j variable I. Okay, so it will works because I variable so iterates for 4 times only, right? So that's why you won't get so j variable values so 5 and these you won't get, guys. Okay, 5 and 6 iterations will be not executed. Okay, good. ID number A0. Already I explained in the yesterday session, right? Difference of times. So just make use of that so inbuilt function, okay? Difference time. So for that one, take a end time and next to that start time. Okay. So if you take that one, so it will be executed. Okay. So it is not required. So apart from that discussion, so extra discussion is not required for that. Enough. Okay. So just keep that code. So have that function ma. So keep that function in that so code, okay, if you get in that drive, so it will be executed. Okay, it is enough. That's good. Observe this so code ma. Okay, I kept in the chat box, so have it. Okay, next of all, let us move on to the next one ma. So observe this pattern. It is easiest pattern only. So all of you go through this pattern. Okay. Ones, twos, threes, fours, fives, and six. Okay. So six rows and so six different values, guys. Okay. Yes. See, actually we are so not focusing on this one ma, actually because of discussing these things. Actually we are not discussing so C language or else anything ma. See, it is a company specific training ma. See, all of you people listen one thing, guys. Company specific training means you people should come with some back end knowledge, guys, regarding all this. So here just we focus on so whatever you will get in the drives only. Okay, so again, if we go for discussing the concepts and everything, means it will become delay. So we cannot focus on this thing. Okay, so it will be diverted. So that is the thing. So that's why here I am focusing on this one. Okay, so all of you, so please support here and Abzoma. Okay, yes, here still we need to discuss so many coding questions. We are left over with so many coding questions. Okay, all of you focus on this one more. That is nothing but square pattern, right? Okay, so square pattern means you know this thing. Okay, so I think so first of all I explained the square pattern only by the time of explaining patterns. Okay, so same number of rows and next to that so columns. Okay, so I loop and j loop should be same, right? I loop 1, I is equals to 1, I less than or is equals to n, I plus plus s. There is no problem in it. Okay, so there is no problem with this one. And so observe this for loop, guys. Here we are having problem. So that is j variable is initializing so with I here. So this one should be initialized with 1, right? Yes, everyone given correct answer here. Okay, so j should be starts with so 1 here, simple. Okay, apart from this, any more changes more? I think so, no more changes. We should print I variable value only, right? Okay, so I variable value is 1. Okay, while so j moves from 1 to 6. Okay, I variable value is fixed. Okay, So that I variable value 1 so will be repeated for 6 number of times. Okay, so like this. So it is a correct one. Okay, we should print I variable value only here. Okay, so this is correct. There is no problem in it. It works fine, guys. Okay, so now observe this one. Let us move on to the next one. I'll write this problem statement from here. Okay, given n, so print n to 0, guys. Okay, so n value is given to us, we should print values from n to 0, guys. Okay, that is a simple problem statement, but given code fails to print it. Okay, I hope so each and everyone understood this. So n variable is given now, so we should print values from n to 0 here. Okay, that's good. Observe now. For the given code, identify logical error and fix it so that we can get the desired result output from n to 0. Okay? So we should get so values from n to 0, guys. Okay. Backslash n. Okay, first of all, so check like this. First of all, understood the code, I'll explain it. Okay, so listen, I value is taking so let us consider so I value is 5, guys. Okay, so I value so is copying into this one. Okay, n value is copying into I variable here. Okay, so next of all, this condition is checking here, so 5 greater than or is equals to 0. So okay, here one problem is there, that is a backslash n, okay, is required. Next, I minus minus. Okay, so I value is decrementing by 1. Okay, so 4 3 2 1 you'll get. Okay, yes, ID number A3, what we should use instead of unsigned. Okay, so simply we should not use anything. Okay, so int only. If you use int, what happens in automatically in the back end, so signed will be appended. All of you listen at once. Okay, here one more error is there, so that is unsigned. Are you observing this one? So if you take unsigned, what happens? Observe everyone. Okay, listen now. So let us take n value as some 2. Okay, so first of all, it compares like this: 2 greater than or is equals to 0. Okay, next of all, 1 greater than or is equals to 0. Okay, next of all, so 0 greater than or is equals to 0. Okay, after comparing like this, so what happens means, observe guys, it won't move to this one. Okay, minus 1 greater than or is equals to 0, it won't move to this part, guys. The reason is we are taking unsigned, right? So you know about the range of unsigned. Okay, so let us take 1 byte. Okay, if you take 1 byte, what is the range? 0 to, so 255. Okay, so means values will be exist in between this range only. Okay, so 0 to 255 only, so you won't get after completion of so 0 again, it will move to this value. Okay, so it will rounds, so it will repeats in clockwise direction, guys, like this. Okay, so here also it will performs the same thing, guys. Okay, so once again it will move to this one. Okay, 32,000, so 768, you know about the ranges of integer, right? So it will checks like this. Okay, greater than or is equals to 0. Okay, greater than or is equals to 0 means this is true. Okay, once again it will goes on check like this. Okay, up to 0, once again it will repeats, means we are observing infinite loop here. So how we can overcome this infinite loop means, observe guys everyone. So one thing is we should remove this unsigned, guys. Okay, from this one, and next of all here, so black backslash n, guys. Okay, these two changes we should made here. Okay, for this one I hope so, only two changes only into this one. Now we should make only these two changes now. Okay, fine. Next. So find the factorial of a given number. Okay. So factorial program ID is Absono. So you can easily make changes into this one. Infinite loop. So why? Okay, ma. 1 minute. ID number 96. Listen, ma. See, ma, are you observing this one? So let us take so n value 2, ma. Okay. So what you are observing here? So that n value is taking into, so copying into I variable, right? So means I value, so will get 2 here. So this is unsigned, ma. Okay. You know about the range of so unsigned. Okay. So what is the range of unsigned, ma? 0 to 65535. Okay. 65535 is the range of so unsigned. Okay. And you know the range of so this one. So signed -32,768. Okay. To 32,767. Okay. This is the range of integer in a 32-bit operating system. If it is 2 bytes, okay. See, now what happens here means, listen, ma. First of all, so 2 compares like this, ma. Okay. 2 greater than or is equals to 0. So this one is true. Next of all, 1 greater than or is equals to 0. This is true. Next of all, 0 greater than or is equals to 0. It is true. Okay. What happens after this? Listen, this one so gives you true. This one gives you true. Okay, this one also gives you true. So after this, what happens? It won't so moves to this value, guys. Okay, minus one. If it moves to like this minus one, then so loop will be terminated, guys. Okay, it is unsigned, right? So unsigned means so what happens if you decrement I variable by 1? Okay, so then it will move to this position, guys. 65535. Okay, it will move to this position. Okay, I will explain. So with the Dev C++, listen now. Ma, you know this range, right? So char ch is equals to, so all of you try to answer for this one, ma. Okay, so 127. Okay, so printf. So here I'm printing the range of karma. Okay, so ch, but tell me so what is the range size of char? So char size is 1 byte. Okay, 1 byte means 8 bits. Okay, 8 bits means so 2 power 8. So 2 power 8 value is 256. Okay, so now automatically in the back end, so here for this signed char, signed will be appended, guys. Okay, so if you want to print only positive values, then explicitly we should assign as unsigned, guys. Okay, so signed char ch. So now this one, so having range, so -128 to 127. Okay, so this one is having range -128 to 127, guys. So this one unsigned char ch is having the range 0 to 255. Okay, means this one can print the characters in this range. So signed character can print so values in this range. Okay, so now here what you'll get, so for this one you'll get 127 only. Okay, so but if you try to assign so this one 128, so do we have so 128 value in the signed char range? But can you tell me what is output for this one? Ma, listen carefully. No, not 0, not 1. Oh, what is output for this one? Here I am printing the range of char with the help of percentile. Very good, Niharika. -128. Ma, listen. Ma, here what we are observing, we are trying to assign a out of range value of char. Okay. Ma, this is very important MCQ for a TCS drive. So many years, so nearly 2 to 3 years, the same MCQ was given. Okay. So in Absoma here, after completion of so 127, we are not having any value. Okay, so next to 127 value, if you try to assign some other value again, it will start printing from the starting position. Okay, Again, it will start the printing from the starting position, guys. Okay, now listen, ups output. So what we are getting, minus 128, right? So because of assigning 128, it is out of range value. If you try to assign out of range value, again it will start so printing values from the starting position. Okay, so but now listen guys, now in our program what you are observing, if unsigned CH is equals to 256, ESMA, if it is unsigned, so then we can print it. Observe, unsigned char, observe output. If it is unsigned, you can print it, ma, 128. So just now only I showed you range, right? 0 to 255, ma, okay? Not 256. If you try to print 256, again, it will start printing from 0, ma, okay? Okay, I will show you. So that one, observe. Okay, ma. Okay, fine. Ma, you guys should have so this basic knowledge, then only so you can so complete this automata part, guys. Otherwise, we can discuss only just some 8 coding questions. That's it. We cannot finish this one, guys. It is not possible to finish automata. So if you have knowledge on this, then only we can complete all this very quickly. Fine. Okay. My likewise. Now what is so okay, my ID number 496. Thank you. See, Abzo, what is happening here is so we are trying to assign like this now, minus 129. So this is out of range, right? If you try to assign as out of range value, so in the negative values also. If you try to assign as out of range values in the negative, what happens? It will print the positive position. Again, it will move to the so forward position, guys. Okay. So like this. It will move to the positive values. See, observe. It moves to the so 127 value now. Okay. Minus 129 means we are not having negative characters. Okay. Negative characters means it is related to the positive characters ASCII values only. Okay. So 127 value will be printed. Okay, that's it. So here also the same thing is happening, ma. Okay, in our program also. That is, listen. Actually, it is so comparing like this. We take an n variable value, that is 2, right? First of all, it is compared. So with 2 greater than or is equals to 0, 1 greater than or is equals to 0. And so 0 greater than or is equals to 0. So afterwards, so it was moved to the 65535 greater than or is equals to 0. It moved like this after 0. So if you reduce 0, ma, listen, if you reduce 0 by 1, it will move to 65535, ma. Okay, so not to minus 1. If it is unsigned, okay, so it will move to 65535. If it is signed, so then it will move to minus 1. Okay. Deepika Tiwari. You can change I not is equals to 0 in while loop. Ma, whatever the changes you want, you can make it, ma. Okay. So whatever you want, so you can make it, and we want correct output, ma. That's it. Okay. We want to print the same output. That's it. So you can make so changes in this one. So or else you can make changes in this one, whatever, wherever you required. Okay, you can make it. So but here I am suggesting few changes here. Okay, so if you want, by making some other changes also, we can execute the code. Okay, that's good. So here one change more, and so here another change, totally 2 changes more. Okay, that's good. Next, let us move on to the next one more. So factorial program. Fact value 1, very good. First of all, fact is 1. Here one mistake is there, so that is f value. We should take so 1 here first of all. Okay, good. Next, any more changes? I less than or is equals to n. Very good. I less than or is equals to n. Here this one ma. See, listen, we should print up to that particular position, right? I less than or is equals to n. Means if you take n value 5 ma, okay? So we should print so this value, right? So 5 factorial is 120, okay? We should print this one. Means up to multiplying up to this value 5 only, then only you'll get 120, okay? Percentile LD, ID number A3 as good. So listen ma, here we should use this format specifier ma, LD, okay? So by using this one, so we can print so output in this long int format, okay? That's good. Next, apart from this, any more changes ma? I think so. These are the few changes required, okay? Okay ma, fine. So why long int is required means, I will explain ma. But this is very important one, okay? You should remember, guys. Everyone should remember this thing. So 1 minute, I will explain this one. So with their C++, all of you listen ma. This is important for drives also, okay? And for interviews also, I told you, this is the very important program, okay? So listen ma. That's why I'm explaining this program here. Why we should take so long here, abzoma, okay? Ma, here we take long, okay? Actually, long is not suitable. Ma, you people also do one thing, okay? So you people try with so long, okay? If it is not possible, so check with this long, okay? So here in this one, so long is not possible. I will show you with long also, okay? It is possible with only long, okay? So abzoma. So long int fact is equals to 1, okay? So next of all, so n variable and I variable, okay? So take input for so n, guys, okay? Percentile, how we should take so input ma here, abso. So for this one, long is not required, guys, okay? Only for fact long is required. Yeah, for n and I, long is not required, long, okay? So percentile d ampersand n, okay? Next, observe here. For I is equals to 1, I less than or is equals to n, I plus plus, okay? So fact is equals to fact into I, okay? Next of all, outside of this one. So print factorial with the help of percentile LLD ma, okay? A percentile LLD for long int, okay? Listen ma. So why I am showing this one, so why we are taking a long int only means, you can understood now, okay? Abzama, what is the n variable value I am going to take here? Observe everyone, guys, I am taking value 19, okay? So imagine, what is the factorial value of this 19? So you'll get nearly 18 digit number as result, okay? So do we can store so 18 digit number result in the integer? Just now only you observe the ranges of integer, okay? So that is 0 to 65536. If it is a 64 bit operating system, we can store up to 4 billion value only, okay? 10 digit number, that's it. But if you want to store more than 10 digit number, you should use these type of type modifiers, guys, okay? My observe output, everyone. How many digits are there in this value? Count it, guys. 18 digits you can find. 1, 2, 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18. Means if you want to print these type of things, it is not possible with normal integer. Okay. yes, ma. Deepika, same. It is correct. And so listen now. If you do, Sigma, just if you do, forgot, so this one here. So taking type modifier, then your code will be not execute, guys, okay? Only it will execute for these type of values, guys, 5, 6 only, okay? So it will be not executed for value 19. It will be not executed. So if you so forgot this one, okay? So you should take that one only. So I will show you now output. If you take int here, okay? So observe ma. See, what is the value we are getting here? Some gap based value we are getting, guys. Okay, that too is a 9-digit number it is. Okay, so this is not correct. Okay, but don't forget this one for factorial program. So you should think about the result before going to declare variables in your program. You should think about the result, how we get result. Okay, so for different types of values you should think about the result only, not for certain values. Okay, so then you can understood which type modifiers we should take for that one, all these. Okay, that's good. Now I hope so everyone understood ma. For finding factorial of 100, what we are supposed to take? Big integer also didn't works. This was asked in challenge in GFG. Okay, fine. I do didn't observe till now. So okay, ma, let me check. I will check it once. Okay. So if we are having anything, so definitely we'll be having some way. I think so. This is the last way, ma. So by using the long. So apart from this long, we are not having any other type modifier. Okay. This is the last one. Long. Actually in Python all this it is not required to take this one more. By default it returns the values, okay, in that format. 1 minute, so let me check for 100 now what you'll get. Okay, we are not getting result. Okay, 1 minute, so we change it this format specifier, right? Sorry, 1 minute. Percentile LLD, right? Hundred. Okay, so although we take this one, we are not getting result for 100. Most probably we do not take those type of values. We take 19 factorial only, these type of values only. So that's why it is designed. So if we are having anything, we can check it. Okay. What is double, ma? ID number 254. I cannot understood. We cannot take double. Ask your doubt once again. Okay, fine. That's enough. I will check it that one. So till now I too didn't face that that type of question. I will check at once. Okay. Yes. Okay, ma, fine. So definitely, ma. Deepika, so if I found that one, definitely, so I will share it to you. Okay. Yes. Fine. Now let us move on to the next one. Greatest of three numbers code, ma. So you can easily complete this one. So all of you give me logic for this one. It is not all matter. Give me ternary operator expression for this one. Yes, ma, ternary only, not if else. If else is not required. If it is for two or three numbers, so ternary enough. Okay, you can easily finish it off. A greater than B. Quick, ma. A greater than B question mark. Afterwards, A greater than C. First of all, you should compare. So A with B and next to that C, right? Okay. So A greater than C. If it is true, so you should print A, guys, here. Okay. So if only this expression is false, A greater than C is false, then at that time you should print C value here. Okay. So next of all, if this expression itself is false, if the first one itself is false, so then at that time it will execute this one, guys. Else block. In else block, you should compare. We compared A with B, A with C, right? We didn't compare B with C. Okay. So we should compare so with B with C nice. Okay, B greater than C question mark. So B colon C, that's it. That's very good. So here few members given correct logic. No, okay, that's good. So this is a simple program, right? So you can so I think so you can easily finish it off. So these type of programs, it is not all matter. Okay, let us move on to the next one now. Okay, so converting binary to decimal. So this one also we should complete, guys. Okay, binary to decimal means if you take so input as like this now. Okay, 100, we should print so 10. Okay, so this is binary one. Okay, so for this binary form we should print so decimal form, guys. Okay, we should print decimal form for this. If you required, so if you ask, so I will explain. Okay, no problem. So or else let us move on to the next one. If you know this thing, binary to decimal. Do you want this code? How many of you want this code? Just so those who want, explain. Okay, okay, fine, 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 definitely. Okay, let us see. So this program first of all. Okay, so first of all, Abzoma, 1 0 1 0. Okay, so you all know this thing. Okay, 2 cube and so 2 square, 2 power 1 2 power 0. Okay, so 2 cube 8, 2 square 4, 2 power 1, 2, 2 power 0, 1, you'll get, okay? So now the thing is, you should multiply all these things, okay? So on multiplying this, 1 into 8 plus 0 into 4 plus 1 into 2 plus 0 into 1, okay? So you'll get like this, 1 into 8, 8 plus 0 plus 2 plus 0. Okay, what you'll get, guys? 10. So for binary value 1010, okay, so you'll get so decimal value 10, guys. Okay, yes. So now let us see this code, guys. Simply what you are observing here, listen my everyone, we should retrieve each and every value so from this binary value, right? Okay, after retrieving each and every value, you should compare with so 2 powers. Okay, so this 2 power value should be incremented. So on moving to the so previous values, okay, and so with the 2 power values, you should multiply these values, okay, each and every position value, and afterwards you should add, okay. So you should add that value to the so remaining values, okay. Afterwards you should reduce number of digits, okay. So you all know how we can so reduce this one. So modulus division of 10, you'll get 0. So 1010 divided by 10, you will get 101. Okay, so I hope so you know it, this one. Okay, so this 0 value should be multiplied with so 2 power 0. Okay, so you'll get some result. Okay, so 0, that one should be added. Okay, so with the next one, so 101 modulus division of 10, you'll get so 1 now. Okay, next of all, 101 divided by 10, you'll get 10. Okay, next of all, what you should do, guys? So this 1 value should be multiplied so with the 2 power 1. So what you'll get? 2. This 2 value should be added with previous value, that is 2. Okay, so like Visma, what you are observing, simply multiplication, addition, and next to that so retrieving each and every digit and reducing number of digits by 1. Okay, so observe directly. I will go with so programmer, simple one it is. And opposite to this one, you can you'll get this memo. Okay, decimal to binary. So these programs are very important for TCS drive. Okay, so these type of conversion programs are important for TCS. Okay, listen, first of all so let us take this one. Okay ma, 1 minute. Sorry. What we should take input, guys? We should take input as so binary, and we should convert into decimal, right? Okay, into binary decimal. Okay, and so for power I am taking I variable. Okay, I variable for powers. My initially power value is zero, right? Okay, so next of all, so sum variable, let us not require sum. Okay, so listen now. While so binary value, until binary value is going to become zero, we should keep on repeating so this one, guys. Okay, so that is decimal value should be added. Initially we should take our decimal value to zero. Okay, listen, decimal is equals to decimal plus zero value should be added with, so what did we should add, guys? So binary value we should we should get the last digit from this binary, right? So for getting a last digit, so what we should do, binary modulus division of so 10. Okay, and next of all, so this value should be multiplied so with this one, guys. Okay, so 2 power sorry, here we should use this function, power function. Okay, so if we do not want power function, means we are having some other procedure. Okay, so that is the lengthiest one. Okay, left shift operator we can use it. So we are having some procedures with that, I can use it. So observe this one more, power of so 2 comma I. Okay, so this one is present in the math header file. Fine, ma. Observe here. So power in power comma power of 2 comma I here. Okay, next of all, what you should do, guys, we should reduce binary value by 1, guys. Binary is equals to, so binary divided by 10. Okay, so next of all, so here I variable value should be incremented by 1, right? I is equals to, so I plus 1. Okay, simply outside of this one, so you can go for printing this value, guys. Percentile D decimal. Okay, this one is so program for so binary to decimal. Okay, so observe output, my everyone. Okay, 1 minute. Power of 2 comma 0.
Not take input of binary, sir.
Okay, fine. So we forgot that one, right? Okay, sorry, we forgot this one. So ampersand so binary, right? Yes, absoma. So 10. Okay, so if you just reverse these variables, okay, then so we can finish that one. So decimal to binary. Okay, so but that is not required. Okay, for us, so just have this knowledge, guys. Enough. Abzama, see, simply we are taking binary value. Until binary value is going to become zero, what we are doing, we are retrieving each and every digit with the help of so this operation, and we are multiplying so with so power. What happens if we take other than zero and one? Well, this is binary to decimal conversion program. This is not some other program. For binary means zeros and ones only, right? You'll be not having 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. My Dell, understood? Okay. Fine. Abzono. And so we are multiplying so with so power of 2 comma I 2 power 0, 2 power 1, all this. And each and every time we are reducing by one digit. So we are incrementing outside of this one, we are printing decimal. Okay. So now simply if you interchange this one more, so binary value taking 0, okay. So decimal value taking input like this. If you interchange this more, okay. So then program, one more program will be finished. Decimal. See, instead of decimal, you should take binary. That's it. Instead of binary, you should take decimal. Okay. So here, instead of binary, decimal. Here, instead of modulus division of 2, 2. Okay. Instead of modulus division of 2, this is 2. Okay. So here also it is 2. So we are converting into, so 2, right? Okay. So in this way, you should take this. And so instead of power, you should take like this, guys. Okay. You should take I variable. Initially, you should take I variable. You should take 1. Okay. And each and every time I variable should be multiplied with 10. Okay. Earlier, we taken powers, right? So that's why I variable is incremented. But now, so we should move on to the left side positions, right? Okay. So we get so values like this. Okay. So that is 10. So now 10 modulus division of 2 means so 0. So 0 will be multiplied with 1. You'll get 0 here. Okay. Next of all, what happens now? Here we should change variables, right? Decimal divided by 2. Okay. So 10 divided by 2, what you'll get? 5 here. Okay. So next of all, I variable should become 10 here. Okay. Next of all. So decimal variable value, that is so 5 now, it is updated here. 5 on dividing with this one. So 2. 5 modulus division of 2, what you'll get, guys? 1. So 1 into, so 10. You'll get 10 now. See, observe, we are moving to the tens place, hundreds place, thousands place like this, okay? So each and every time we are shifting to the previous positions. That's why we are taking I is equals to I into 10, guys, okay? So simply we are converting, so this one, right? A decimal value, that's why we are taking 10 here, okay? And so here we are converting into binary, right? That's why in the denominator, we are taking 2 here. Do you observe, ma? Earlier we taken 10. So now we are taking 2 here. Simply if you reverse this one, every variable and so tens into twos and I variable values, all this, so program will be finished, guys. Okay. So 10, what you'll get next of all? So 5 divided by 2, you'll get so 1, and next of all I variable becomes 100. So 1 modulus division of so 2, what you'll get? 1 only. Okay. 1 minute more. 5 divided by 2, right? 2 more. Sorry. Okay. 2 modulus division of 2, 0. Okay. 0 into 100, you'll get so 0 only plus so 10. What you'll get? 10 only. Okay. So the total you'll get so 10 more. Okay. 0 into 100 plus so 10, you'll get 10 here. Next of all, what happens? Which PDF more? You're asking the present one. Now, how I can share more? Actually, I'm not present in your any of your groups and all this, right? So I will tell this thing, okay? So to some other person who is in charge for this, okay? So to share this one, definitely I will share this one more. There is no problem because now I am explaining this one only. Okay, Telegram group or else Discord. Okay, ma, fine. Definitely. After completion of this one, let us share this one. Okay. Fine, ma. Okay, ma. Definitely, ma. Item number 2. See, 5 divided by so 2 is equals to 2. Okay, ma. Listen. What you'll get? 2 here. And so next of all, what you'll get, guys? Decimal value now 2. 2 divided by 2, you'll get 1. Okay. I value increments to 1000, guys. Now, okay. So now what happens here? Abzoma. This is the last step. Okay. Now what is the decimal value? A decimal value is 1. 1 modulus division of 10. What is result? 1. 1 into 1000. I value is so 1000, right? Okay. 1 into 1000 plus previous value, that is 10. Okay. So plus 10. What you'll get, guys? 1010. Okay. You'll get like this. Simply what we are doing, so earlier we taken decimal value as 0, okay? Now we are taking binary value as 0. We are taking input for decimal. Earlier we taken as a binary. Here we are taking decimal. Earlier we taken binary, okay? So we changed each and every binary variable into decimal, decimal into binary, simply, okay? And we changed these things, guys, okay? We are taking 2 here because we are converting into binary, right? That's why we are taking this. And earlier we taken I variable value 1. So but here we are going to multiply with the I variable, right? So that's why we take an I variable 1 and we change this expression also regarding I. If you remember these things, you can easily finish it, guys. Okay, observe output for this one. So 10 1010, okay? Yes, we got correct output here. Okay, that's good. Okay, ma, definitely. So I'll give you a break. Take some 5 minutes gap, okay? Afterwards, let us see the remaining so coding questions, okay? Fine. Yes. Let us move on to the next coding question, ma. So observe here. Sorry, ma. 1 minute. I forgot to explain this one. See here, in this, it is clearly given, ma. Okay. So you do not expect to modify the approach or else to incorporate any additional library methods. Okay. So without using any library methods, that is, we use it power, right? Okay. Without using that one, so we should complete this one. Okay. Yes. So Abzoma. Now, first of all, let us discuss this one. So previous coding question. Without inbuilt methods. Okay. So that is, let us delete this one, guys. Okay. So math header file. Yes, Abzoma. Without so inclusion of so math header file, okay. So we cannot use this one, right? Power function, okay. So how we can design this one, ma? Listen, I think so you understood. Actually, we should write this program. We know all this. So with the power function, okay. So without power function here in this location, okay. So how we can so finish this program? So that is the thing, guys. Okay. So we are having a number of ways, ma, here. So to do this thing, okay. So that is by the time of so taking this one, we can take so one variable, guys. Okay. That is I variable only. So with the help of the, that I variable only, so we can observe like this. Okay, here I will show you one of the method. Might be we may have different methods. Okay, so observe here. I will show you one of the method. User defined function. Okay, very good. So 496 with user defined function. So we can calculate. Okay. So base and next to that exponent each and every time. So okay, fine. Or else have that format only. Okay. Listen, ma. Let us take so one user defined function power. Okay. So in the base, so pass this one two. Okay. And in the power, so take this one, guys. Okay. So and next to that each and every time increment I variable by one. So and next to that go for so taking this one. Okay. So int power of so base and next to that exponent, you all know this thing. Actually, I explained this program in the so Python language itself. Okay, so until exponent value is going to become zero, I explained with recursion, right? Okay, so we should keep on multiplying base, so that base value, so that final value we should return to this one. Okay, yes, this is one of the way. Okay. Ah, yes, ma. Fine, ma. I know this ID number 213. Listen, ma. Actually, just I am showing here. I am not writing and I am not typing program here. I am showing you the format. Okay. So we are not having enough time to so take all these things. Okay. So you have knowledge on this one, right? So taking user defined function. Okay. Yes. So I have that. Okay, ma. Already ID number D2 given code here. Okay. I explained with recursion. So the same program you can make use of. Okay, remember this thing, ma. Don't use inbuilt so library functions. Okay, I said the same thing by the time of discussing Python also. Okay, so in some drives they won't allow to use inbuilt functions, ma. That's why hard coding is required. Okay, so you should have knowledge on each and every function, ma. Factorial function, power function, all these are there in the math header file, right? Okay. So although we should make use of this one, yes, ma. By setting so ith bit to one, we can we can calculate power also in that format. Okay, no problem. We are having number of ways. Okay, so that is the easiest one. Actually, user defined function, everyone can easily remember that. Okay, that's good. Now let us move on to the next one, ma. So print prime numbers from an array up to given so value. Okay. So up to given value, we should print so prime numbers. Okay, that is the code. Observe everyone, guys. So just so give me logic in this part, ma. Okay. So you are observing int is prime int num, right? Okay. So here from this if block, so here from this if condition, so we are calling this one is prime of m. Okay. If it is true, so we should return so integer value. Value means one or else zero. Okay, if it is true, we should return one. One means it reads that one as true here. Okay, if we return zero from this one, it will consider that one as false. Okay, based on that, so those values will be stored into this array variable, guys. Okay, finally, all those values, all prime numbers, whatever stored into this array will be printed. Okay, so you all know the logic of this one. So prime, again, it is not required, I think so, to explain. Things we already discussed this one in the Python itself. My flag variable taking to zero, you all know this, right? Okay, things so once again explanation is not required for this. That's why I am directly moving to the next one. Okay, but do anyone want this logic for prime? Okay, fine, thank you. Good, next. This one is not required. We already calculated this one, and so this one, just from here onwards, we should correct errors. Yes, ma, do it quickly from pointers. Ampersand where, ma, where we should take ampersand? PTR is equals to ampersand. Very good, Deepika, good. Line 5, yes, very good. See, you all know this thing, right? Observe this line. See, here A is normal variable, P is PTR is pointer variable. Okay, so to pointer variable, we should assign the address of so normal variable, right? Like this. Okay, so PTR is equals to ampersand A. We should assign like this, right? So here error is there. Apart from this, any more errors, ma? Check everyone once again. I think so, no more errors so present, ma. Only one error. Okay, that's it, only one error. So that is address of A should be assigned to pointer variable. Okay, ma, observe the corrected code, ma, here. So here, from here onwards, I'll give you the corrected code also. Okay, so observe the corrected code. Ampersand A, so here the corrected part is displaying, so is highlighting, ma, so with the green color. You can observe this here. I so converted that so high part into green color. Okay, you can check it, guys. That's good. Now let us move on to the next one. Simply you can observe this thing. So directly observe the coding question, understood, ma, what is that program, and so try to correct the errors in that. Okay, I will explain. So program, all of you listen, ma. Here array is taken, so with values 1 2 3 4 5, so pointer variable is declared, and next to that so length is defined, ma, okay, with the help of this one, and so array is assigned to pointer, I variable is taken, so traversing, so with the help of for loop. Okay, and next of all, so array values are printing here. Okay, with the help of this one, pointer array. Okay, so here few members so given logic. 1 minute, let me check. So PTR is equals to array of 0 ampersand of array. Ma, listen, why you are focusing on this one? Ma, this is array. Ma, this both these are same, ma. Okay, ma, in array concept, although if you pass this one, ma, you observed in this function calling, right? Ma, how I pass it functions? Listen, I pass it functions like this, right? I will keep in the chart box. Okay, so product matrix, so we call, right, product matrix. How I call this one? So rows, columns, and so some variable a. Like this we pass it, right? But listen, by passing like this array, so we retrieved with the help of asterisk symbol, right? So in the called function, but here it is not required. Ampersand is not required. This one itself acts as address, okay? Yes, ma. Size of array. This one here we are having one mistake, okay? Yes, ma. We use so listen, ma. That is the error actually. Size of spelling is wrong. Yes, this one here you are observing uppercase O letter, right? This is not correct, ma. Okay? So we should have lowercase O. Lowercase O. And one more error is there, ma. So what is that error? Ma, just simply we are converting so normal array into pointer array, ma. Okay? ID number 4D2. Now it is not required. So dynamic memory allocation is not required. Simply we are assigning so array values into this pointer. Okay, we are using that one more. It is not required now. Size of, apart from this, one more change is also required more. Here one of the student given this ID number A3. Ma, size of array, is it correct? You asked correctly. Okay, so tell me, is it correct? But check this one, everyone. Size of array, is it correct? Yes, very good. 255 given, so correcting here. But size of, so size of is the just like this one, right? We should use curly braces, okay? So we should not use rectangular braces, right, for this one. So this is not correct, ma. This is correct, okay? So here one error is there regarding that. Okay, now I'll keep all the errors observed. So here O should be in uppercase. Okay, and so here we should take curly braces. Okay, so two errors are there totally. Only two errors. We can execute this one. So after correcting these two errors, we can execute this one. So this program is simply pointers to, sorry, array to pointer array conversion. Okay, so array to pointer array conversion program. So this is the normal array. We are printing values with the help of pointer now, okay? Because in array, actually values will be stored in continuous memory locations, right? So that's why we are taking this expression here. Plus of I means so zero memory location. Next of all, pointer plus one. One means next memory location. So in the next memory location, you can find this one, okay? Like this. Initially, so pointer points to the so base address of array, okay, the starting values, the starting address of this one array. So afterwards, with the help of this expression, so we are fetching the next memory location values here, okay? So only two changes are required, ma. One thing is this one and another one is so O letter, okay? That's it. Very good. Observe corrected code, ma, everyone. Two changes only, okay? Size of array, next to that size of so this one letter of so O letter should be converted into lowercase, okay? That's good. Next, let us move on to the next one, ma. I'll explain this program at once, listen everyone. Ma, 1 minute, listen, wait. I will ask you, okay? So by that time onwards, you can start answering, okay? So till by that time, just wait everyone. So array values are taken here, size is calculating, and so we are calling display array of length, okay? So observe here, we are using double asterisk. Double asterisk is not required, ma, first of all. Only single asterisk is required. Yes, very good. Here few members so given logic already. That's good. Next of all, observe this one also. Here also double asterisk is not required, okay? In printing part, ma, in printing part also double asterisk is not required. Single asterisk symbol is enough, okay? With the help of this one we can print it. Apart from this, any more errors, ma? Check everyone. I think so. No more errors are there apart from this. Oh, okay, ma'am. Fine, fine. So no problem. Yes, ma'am. We use double asterisk for multi-dimensional arrays, ma'am. Rekha, correct. Okay. Ma, return type is so void only. There is no problem with return type, ma'am. Okay. ID number 213. It is correct. Void only. So just we are calling display, right? Okay. So here it is not required to return anything, ma. Here itself we should print this one. Okay. Fine. I think so only two errors are there, ma, in this one. Absolutely. Corrected code. Okay. So here I corrected. So in one more location also, in this one also, but I highlighted only this location. Okay. Ma, consider these two. So parts are corrected here. Okay. So here we removed a double asterisk, and here also we removed double asterisk. Okay. Yes. Why did we divide length with size? Ma, this is one of the way of calculating so size of array. Okay. Okay. I will explain this one. Ma, we are having so different ways here or to calculate. So this is one of the way. So size of array. What is so size of array here? So simply, how many values are there? Five values. Okay. So five values. So on multiplying so with this one. So integer value 4, what you'll get, guys? 20. So 20 bytes of memory will be allocated for this one. Okay. So it is dividing with so size of array. Okay. Size of array of 0. So what is the size of one particular value here? So that is a 4. Okay. So on dividing so 20 with so 4, what you'll get? So 5 only, right? Okay. But this one we use it in for some other purpose. Okay. So now it is not required for you. So just so have this knowledge, okay? Enough. So with this one also, you'll get length only, okay? Now for you, this one is not required. Just to focus on so correcting errors, okay? So by the time of discussing, so if I get opportunity to discuss so C language, definitely I'll discuss all this, okay? So but we discuss it Python language, right? Okay. We didn't discuss it all these things, okay? Again, if we discuss all these things, two-dimensional pointers, all this, it will take much time, okay? So actually in CRT, we should discuss all these, okay? In CST, it is not possible more to discuss concepts and make sure that, so company-specific related coding questions, MCQs and all these, okay? Yes. And next. Next, ma. I will explain this one. First of all, listen, wait, everyone, don't answer. Okay. So here array is declared, array values are taken. Okay. And next to that, I variable is declared. So pointer variable is declared here. Okay. Absoma, everyone. Pointer variable is declared. Okay. And next to that, this one is not required. Okay. Address ampersand symbol is not required. Okay. Yes. Very good. PTR. So asterisk PTR here, this one is not correct. And this part is not correct. Okay. And so this memory location, actually it is printing and it is moving to the next locations, guys. It is okay. So there is no problem in it. So but observe here, what is the value we taken? 4. So but here we should take value. So 5 here. Okay. See here, we should use so asterisk symbol ma, for pointer. So another thing is we should not use ampersand symbol. And so another thing is we should use the value 5 here. Okay. So these three corrections we should make, guys. Okay. For this code in order to execute. Okay. That's good. Check more. So apart from this, so any more errors are there? So check everyone. I think so. No more errors are there. Let us check the updated one. Okay. Yes. So here you can observe the updated one. Okay. So corrected code, that is. So here we did change. So here we made some change and here also we made some change. Okay. Three changes. No, my asterisk of PTR plus I is not wrong. So here you are observing different ways. So print this one. Here you have got so printing values with the help of this PTR plus I you observed in this format actually earlier. 1 minute. See, earlier in these programs, you observed this one, right? ARR plus I, array plus I. So here you are observing in another format. That's it. Asterisk PTR plus plus. So both are same. So there is no problem in it. Okay. Both are correct. Yes. Next. Fine. Next one. Again, from pointers only. Asterisk so PTR. Yes, okay, very good. So this one, we should make this change, guys. So next of all, okay, ampersand. We should so remove this one, ampersand not required. Okay, and so this one, very good. Here is equals to symbol, and next of all, I variable is not declared here. Okay, so I variable is not declared. Okay, we should declare I variable. So we should take is equals to symbol here, and so we should take so this one, guys. Okay, ampersand should be removed. Okay, these changes we should make here. So asterisk symbol, we should take asterisk here. Okay, and so next this one. So why ampersand is not required? Okay, fine. I will so execute this one at once. Observe. PTR, I think so. So this one, right? Array. Okay. Next of all, this one. I is equals to zero. I less than so 5 I plus plus. Okay, and so next of all this one, printf so percentage d space asterisk ptr so plus plus. Okay, it's good. Now observe. First of all, observe output for this one. As we are getting output here, so there is no problem in it. No? Okay, let us check with so this one. Okay, so ampersand now. ID number 510. You can check it. No? Cannot convert. Are you observing this error? Cannot convert int pointer 5. Okay, so into int pointer in assignment here. Okay, so now it is considering that. So only this first position value. Okay, so he is pointing here. So I have to show you one MCQ here. So one important MCQ is there between all these. Okay, 1 minute. Wait 1 minute, my everyone. Observe this one. See, here you are observing this one, right? An explanation, array and ampersand, okay? So these two points to the base address only, okay? So array means it will point to the first memory location address. Ampersand array means this one also points to the first memory location address only, okay? So by the time of passing this one function call, okay, listen. By the time of passing this one, so to the function call, you can pass like this array or else ampersand array. Okay. So these two, so we can retrieve with the help of asterisk symbol in the called function. Okay. So, but listen. So if you use this one ampersand array for this pointers, so then you will get a problem. Only this one will point to that base address only. Okay. So it cannot convert at the time. It considers that all the memory locations, okay, ampersand RR means, so all the memory locations cannot point to the one memory location. Single pointer variable cannot point to the all the memory locations. So you'll get that problem by the time of listen. 1 minute. See here, there is no difference these two by the time of calling function, okay? So but by the time of assigning to the pointer variable, so by the time this one will assigns only starting value address to this pointer variable, this one will assigns the entire of memory location values to this pointer variable here. So by that time we'll get problem, okay? So the same thing, the same error you observed in that Dev C++ also, okay? Listen, and this one ampersand array of 00 is pointing to the address of the first element array, okay? So by the time, say actually we pass ampersand array of 0 also sometimes, okay? At that time it will points only to the first memory location. Actually all these all similar only. Here you are observing addresses of these, so 1200 and all this, okay? But usage, okay, so usage of these according to the functions and next to the pointers will changes, guys, okay? So this one and this one will changes majorly, okay? So array of 0, array both are same, ampersand array of 0 and ampersand array, okay? So but you can observe difference in these two, guys, array and next to that this one, okay? This one will point to only the first value memory location. This one will point to the entire memory locations of array, guys, okay? So observe that error once again now, okay? I will display that error. Ma, PTR is equals to ampersand ARR. So this one is not same. You can observe here. Okay. So I am explaining the same thing here. Ampersand of array of 0. Oh, okay. 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 Fine. So you are asking this one. Okay, that is fine. That is so that works. Actually, we are not discussing that one. Ma, see, we get output now. So I am sharing output screen. You can observe. Ma, see, one of the student asked this one. Why ampersand is not required? That is ID number 510. So for sake of her, I am explaining this one. Okay, listen. Ma, I hope so. Now you understood. Ma, I just know only I told you with this MCQ. By the time of assigning to the pointer variable, you cannot find any difference of ampersand array and ampersand of array of 0, okay? So that is different. So by that time, ampersand of array of 0 means it will point to the only one memory location. Yes, Ma. Thank you. ID number 510. So here with this one, you can clearly understood, Ma, this. See, just now it works, right? ID number 522 asked one good doubt, Ma. Okay. See, here we use it this one right now. So because of using this one, it is working. Okay. But if we use this one, it is working. Array is working. Ampersand array of 0 is working. So why this one is not working means it is pointing to the all memory locations of array. Okay. So this one will point to only 0th memory location. So to the pointer variable, this one also points to the 0th memory location. Okay. Pointer variable will point to only 0th memory locations if you use this one or else this one. Okay. But in our program, we are not having so this one or else so this one. Okay. So they use it this one. So that's why we removed ampersand symbol. Okay. Thank you, Ma. ID number 510. Fine. Now let us move on to the next one, Ma. One minute. One minute. Okay, now I hope so you understood. So here we should take asterisk symbol for pointer. Okay, here we should remove this ampersand symbol, and here we should declare I variable. Okay, yes, and next of all, is equals to sign is required. I think so. We finished this one, right? 1 minute. I think so. Next one. Okay, fine. I hope so you understood. Be careful. Actually, so you can observe these type of so automata coding questions only, guys. They will so try to confuse you. So in the with these pointers, okay, don't confuse. So remember this thing, ARR ampersand array of 0 is same, okay. So by the time of assigning to pointer, but ampersand ARR is different, okay. So it points at the time, it points to the all memory locations, okay. I think so most probably you'll get so these type of things. And next to that, remember this one, okay. We discussed this single asterisk for retrieving so one array values, ma. Double asterisk for retrieving two dimensional array simply. Okay, so remember this thing. I hope so we discuss these type of things only. Okay, fine. Now let us move on to the next one, ma. Observe the next problem statement. So expected output is this one, ma. 5 4 3 2 1. Okay, I hope so it is visible for everyone. 5 4 3 2 1. We should print like this, guys. Okay, so for that sake, one code is given to us, so just observe that. Okay, 5 4 3 2 1, Ma. Take some time, don't rush, so but give me correct answers. Okay, so here two array values are taken, Ma. 1 2 3 4 5. Okay, and next of all, so pointer 1, pointer 2, two pointer variables taken. Now you can observe, Ma. Here you are you observing, Ma, ampersand of array of 0, ampersand of array of 4. These are correct, Ma, now. These are correct. Now it is, Ma, listen. If you are taking values 0, 4, 2 like this, at that time you should use ampersand, Ma. Okay. So don't forget to use ampersand. Okay. And now ampersand is required. ID number A3 given logic. PTR less than or is equals to PTR 1. Ma, we should print like this. I hope so you observed output 5, so 4, 3, 2, 1. We should print this one. Greater than asterisk. Here we are having problem in this while loop. How we should correct this one? How we should take condition? Not equal. Very good. ID number G7. So pointer 2 not is equals to pointer 1. Okay. We should use this one only, right? Okay, greater than or is equals to pointer to greater than or is equals to 4. What is the fourth position value of 5? Okay, 5 greater than or is equals to 1. Okay, so at that time it will print so 5 value here. Okay, this one will print 5. Let me check ma, 1 minute. Okay, ma, why del? Why not printf after while loop is not required? I'll explain ma. Listen. First of all, observe how it works. Okay, if you take greater than symbol, so 4 greater than 2. Okay, so 3 greater than, so 3. So there itself it will stops. How we can print? So it will print 4. Okay, so afterwards 3 greater than or is equals to 3 means it will print this one also. Okay, so 2 greater than or is equals to 4 means how we can print this one? It is not possible more. Okay, listen, so those type of complicated expressions are not required more simple, so we can simply finish it off. Okay, so pointer 2 not is equals to pointer 1. Okay, so pointer 1 and pointer 2, these two values are not equivalent, so then we can go for so printing values. Okay, so 5 4 3 2 1, all these we can print it. Okay, and next of all, so here one of the student asked why so we take and print f outside of this while loop. Okay, see, listen, it will print so values like this. Okay, so 5 4 3 2 1. Okay, so afterwards up to I think so 2 it will print. 1 minute, let me check. 5 4 3 2, pointer 2 not is equals to pointer 1. Till by that time it will print, and next to that it will so reduces, right? Okay, so it means it will start printing from so this one. Okay, now let me execute this code at once. Okay, let us check so whether printf is required or not. I too will check at once. Okay, observe everyone. No more line greater than or is equals to is not required. So 1 minute, let us execute this so it won't take much time. Okay, already we taken code also, right? So just we should take so two pointers, that's it, right? So ptr1 and ptr2. Okay, and so this one ptr1 we should so take, for ptr1 we should take ampersand of 0, ptr2 we should take so this one ampersand array of 4. Okay, next, listen ma, while loop, while so ptr2 not is equals to ptr1, let us take this one. Okay, first of all, and observe. Okay, okay ma, when wait 1 minute ma, let me check. Printf percentile d asterisk so ptr2 minus minus. Okay, means it will comes to the previous values, guys. Okay, and outside of this one we are having this one, right? Let us see without printing that one. Okay, no more, we got so 5 4 3 2 only. You can observe output more. So we got this one 5 4 3 2. Yes, ma, we need last print statement for printing 1. Okay, the reason is I will explain here. Okay, so 5 will compares with this one, guys, array 4 memory location. So will compares with so array of 0 memory location, array of 4 memory location compares with array of 0, array of 3 memory location with array of 1, array of 2 memory location with array of 1, array of 1 memory location with array of 0 location. Okay, all these memory locations will compare with array of 0 memory location. Okay, so but what happens afterwards, so it will, so pointer 2 also reaches to so this memory location, right? So by that time we are not printing here. Okay, we should print value 1 also onto the output screen, right? Okay, means for that sake what you should do, we are comparing addresses. We are comparing addresses here. Okay, so address of so listen, we are not using asterisk symbol ma. If we are using asterisk symbol, You can easily remember, you can easily find that we are comparing values here, okay? Now we are taking so PTR2, PTR1, ma. If we are taking asterisk symbol, so then you should treat that it is value, okay? If we are taking just PTR1, PTR2 like this, so consider that these are addresses, okay? We are comparing addresses, ma. So whenever we reach to the same memory location, at that time, so what happens? Condition fails. So for the last value, we are printing outside, ma, simply, okay? That's it. PTR2 value will be decremented to 1, okay? After so in the previous one itself, after printing 2, it decrements by 1, okay? That decremented 1 value will print, guys, with this one, okay? MIDI number A4, understood? Now we are comparing addresses, not so this one, values, okay? If we take asterisk, so then at the time, so with the asterisk also, we can also do it, okay? That's good. Observe output, ma, everyone. As we are getting so 5 4 3 2 1 here, there is no problem in it, okay? That's good. Now let us move on to the next coding question, guys. So fine, only one correction we should made. So onto this one, that is pointer 2 not is equals to pointer 1, okay? So here a few members given on logic. So pointer 2 greater than or is equals to pointer 1. So that one is also correct, ma. Listen, we can check it, guys. So pointer 2 greater than or is equals to. So actually next memory locations will be having higher address only, right? So pointer 2 greater than or is equals to pointer 1. Okay, Abzoma. But we are getting 0 here. 1 minute. Might be by that time. So we should remove. Is equals to symbol, ma. Sorry, 1 minute. But those who given this logic, observe at once. Line 10 is not required, or else, so you can remove this is equals to symbol, ma. By removing this is equals to symbol, so we can so do it, guys. Okay, whatever you want, ma, you can make it. Okay, so whether you can delete this one is equals to symbol, or else if you delete printf outside of that, I can print it, guys. Okay. Ma, understood? Those who given so this one greater than, okay, their answer is also correct, ma. Not only not is equals to, so many things were there, okay? In so many ways we can correct the errors, guys, okay? Not only in one way, okay? That's good. Both so two answers are correct, guys. Greater than is correct, and next to that so not is equals to is also correct, okay? So but I taken so not is equals to here. You are observing the corrected code, ma, here. Okay. One minute. Okay, fine. Let us move on to the next one, ma. We should print output like this, ma. Observe this output, everyone. 1 2 3 4 5 6, that's it, okay? So in two lines we should print output, okay? Observe. Observe this code and tell me where error is present, okay? You should have key concentration, guys, on everything. This is two-dimensional array, okay? So we take in so 1 2 3 in the first row, 4 5 6 in the second row. We take in two variables for traversing, I and Z, okay? So I variable repeats for two times, guys, okay? So two rows are there, right? 0 and 1. I variable gets 0 and 1 values, okay? So J variable gets 0 1 2. There is no problem in I loop and J loop, okay? And so next of all, observe here how to print so array values with the pointer. You are observing here, Gama, okay? So listen, how we can print this one? Double asterisk array plus I plus J, okay? So my not single asterisk, my ID number 407. But this is a two-dimensional pointer. Okay. So two-dimensional array, sorry. Find asterisk. So we should take so brackets like this. Okay, one of the student giving logic. Okay, apart from this, ma. Let me check. So here one of the student given logic, we should take curly brace like this. Okay, no ma, it is not required to store in Pyotr. Directly we can print like this also, ma. Okay, so it is applicable. Listen, I less than 3, like I less than 3 is not required, ma. G7, listen. One, two, three, and so 4, 5, 6. Okay. Next. So I and next to that, so J variables. So for I is equals to, so 0, I less than, so 2, I plus plus. Okay. Next. For J is equals to 0, J less than 3. J plus plus. Okay, next of all, so printf percentage d space, we are having like this, right? Okay, so a of sorry, a plus I plus j. Okay, so we are having like this, guys. Okay, absolute a plus I plus j. Okay, and next, so printf so backslash n. Okay, up the output, my everyone. So check whether we are getting output or not. Yes, we are getting. So what is the need of so using so curly brace here, Malizan? Although if you do not take so curly brace, I hope so everyone understood this. Okay, ma, although if you do not take curly brace here, so it will be executed, guys. Okay, so I showed you proof. So now tell me where error is present. Are not I less than 3, array of I z not correct, ma, d not after J. Very good. ID number A4. Very good, ma. That is correct. Extra brace. That's why you should have key concentration. Observe this line, ma. Line 7, everyone. How many open curly braces are there? 1, 2. Okay. But how many braces are closing here? 1, 2, 3. 3 closed braces and 2 open braces. Okay. Ma, space is there here. ID number A3. Space is there. After percentile t. Okay, see here, so this one is not present, ma. So curly brace, ma, you will get these type of so programs only. You should carefully observe these braces, ma, first of all. Okay, so whether all open braces are closed or not, you should check this thing. Okay, so this is important. You will get these type of programs also. Okay, so don't take it silly, guys. Sometimes so you think that the entire code is correct. Okay, see, observe, the entire code is correct, there is no problem. So just you are observing one extra brace here, that's it. Okay, so be careful with this. So observe, guys, the corrected one, extra close parenthesis has removed. Okay, so on removing extra closer parenthesis, so you'll get code like this, guys. Okay, this is the corrected code. Okay, is good. I hope each and everyone understood this. So next one is so silly one, actually. So this one is related to the functions. So here one small problem is there, ma, regarding spelling. Okay, so I will explain this one. Listen, here you are observing multiplication, right, Noma? So here multiplication function spelling you are observing, right? That spelling is not correct, okay? So simply if you make that correction, so you can do it, guys, okay? That's it. This is a simple one. It is not required. Just observe this one more, corrected one, okay? In the corrected one, so we taken this one, multiplication, and I think so in one more change, so we are observing here. Greater than choice is greater than t, we are observing, right? So if choice is less than or is equal to 2, we are observing this. Okay, but simply we are taking all these in functions into some array, guys, okay? Afterwards, we are calling all these functions here, okay? You won't get these type of things, okay? You can leave it. Next. So focus on this one, next one. So observe this output, my everyone. 5 1 so 4 2 3 3 2 4 1 5, okay? We should print output like this with spaces more, okay? So observe the code now. So where error is present, so find out, guys, okay? So earlier also you observed similar type of MCQ. Now small changes you are going to observe, okay? So for that code, a few changes you can observe. So for that code, earlier you observed this one, taking array values for 1 to 5, taking two pointer variables and assigning address of so 0, position value to this one, pointer 1, assigning address of so fourth position value to pointer 2. So simply you are observing while loop here, okay? So I less than or is equals to j, I value is 0, j value is 4, okay? So it will be repeated for so 5 values now, okay? But this loop will be repeated for 5 values, okay? So pointer plus plus, pointer 1 plus plus, pointer 2 minus minus. Very good, ma. Deepika 4G7, good. Ma, not I less than j. I less than or is equals to j is required, ma, okay? See, pointer 1 and pointer 2 values we are printing here, okay? And next of all, here we are observing, so decrementing, so pointer 1, incrementing pointer 2, okay? So how it is possible? Pointer 1, if you decrement, so do we have, so left side of 0th position, do we have any value? No, right? It will move to the minus 1 location, okay? So this is not correct, right? Okay, so means the pointer 1 should be incremented, okay? And you can observe this one also. Pointer 2 is taken to array of 4, right? If you increment this one, so it will move to the so fifth location. So do we have fifth location? No, right? So here, these two, we should interchange these two, guys, okay? So pointer 1, so should be incremented, okay? Pointer 1 should be incremented. And so pointer 2 should be decremented here, okay? So if you change this one, then program will be finishes, guys, okay? Only this thing. And so here I value is incrementing by 1. So by incrementing like this, definitely it will reach us to value 5. It will stop iterating this while loop, okay? You won't get any problem regarding this one. So just you need to change this one, okay? ID number A4 we printed. So what we should print now, how we should print output actually? So 5 and so next of all, so 1, right? 1 minute, let me check output specification. So based on that, let us see whether any more changes are required. So 5 1 4 2, we should print like this, right? So what is a pointer 1 value now? Pointer 1 is pointing to 0, okay? Means it will print so 1, right? So pointer 2 will print 5. Okay, good. So we should interchange these two, right? Yes, ma. Very good. We should interchange these two. So pointer 2, first of all, we should print, guys. Afterwards, so we should print this one, okay? Good, ma. Very good. No, ma. ID number G7, that is not required. We can make that one also, ma'am. Okay, so you can interchange this one, so but that is not required. So just so change, shuffle these two, ma'am. Okay, pointer two first of all print it, afterwards go for printing pointer one. Okay, so fine. I think so. I didn't so updated this one. Fine, ma'am. So only these two changes are required. That's good. Next. I think so, nearly 1 hour completed. Just take some 5 minutes gap. Afterwards, let us discuss remaining things. Okay. Let's wait for some 5 minutes.
Emma, come back everyone. So let us move on to the next one, guys. So read this so problem statement, my everyone. So that is read from here. The function search int array length target, okay, so performs the search operation to look for an element target in the input array. So in the input array of length, if the element is found, the function returns an index, okay, of the target in array. If it is not found, the function returns -1, okay. So this is a search program. In Python, we discussed two search programs, okay, linear search and binary search programs, right? Okay, so let us see which type of searching program is given, okay, whether it is linear search or else binary search. Let us see, guys. Okay, yes, observe input specification and expected return value. Okay, so this is the input specification 10. Okay, so these are the values of the list. Okay, and so this one is the search value 3. Okay, so 3 is the search value. So 3 is present in two locations here, in first location and in third location. But it will always gives you the first location value only, right? Okay, so that's why you are observing expected return value is 1 here. Okay, the existing code is given here. The candidate must remove all the logical errors. Okay, so here you should remove the logical errors. Okay, so observe here, this is binary search program, right? Okay, fine. So low variable is taken to 0, high variable to length -1. Okay, it is correct, there is no problem in it. So low less than or is equals to high, yes, this condition is also correct. Okay, I told you, you should definitely take is equals to more. Okay, if you do not, if you ignore is equals to symbol, so you won't get this one. My ID number D2, it is also correct more. Calculating mid value, okay, like this, because this one is used for overflow ma. Okay, so sometimes we get overflow, right? In order to avoid that overflow, we use this one. Okay, so low minus high minus low divided by 2, this is correct ma. You won't get any problem with this one. Okay, so but observe the remaining things ma. Leave this one, very good. Here few members given logic. So low value mid plus 1, already they found this. Okay, here so this one is not taken, guys. Okay, what we discussed, ma, listen, if it is so mid value is matching with this target value, so we are returning that mid position value here. Okay, so if it is not matching, so what we did, we checked whether so mid value, so target value, so if it is so greater than, okay, than the mid position, we move to the update to the so lower position value, right? So else we update so high position value here. So here there is no problem with this one. Okay, it is correct. This one, observe, guys. So low value we should update with so mid plus 1 here. Okay, so if you do not found after completion of this while loop, observe this curly brace ma. Okay, after completion of this while loop, still if you do not found match, okay, so then finally outside of this we take and return -1. Okay, so there is no problem in it. Okay, so this is correct here. Okay, so but the thing is, listen, ma, here you are observing this expression, right? Mid, so that is low minus you are observing, right? It is not low minus ma, it is low plus. Okay, so low plus high minus low divided by 2. Okay, or else directly you can take this expression, ma, instead of that. So directly you can make use of this one, there is no problem in it. Low plus so high so divided by 2, you can use this expression also, you won't get any problem, guys. So this one is also correct and this one is also correct, guys. You can make use of any of these two. Okay, so actually we add, right, so low value and next to that so high value we add it. Okay, after adding we divide with 2. Okay, So here, instead of adding like this, so in order to overcome overflow, here we use this one, guys, high minus low. Okay, so just remember this thing, you know. Okay, here one error is there, and here so another error is there, guys. Two errors are there in this one. Okay, that's good. Absomo, corrected code here, everyone. Low plus high minus low divided by 2. Okay, and so next of all, this one, low is equals to mid plus 1. Okay, so this is the corrected code, guys. Okay, it's good. Next, let us move on to the next one, guys. Read this problem statement, my everyone. The function, so void order, it receives array and length, accepts an array length, and so function is supposed to accepts an array and length. Okay, and the function is supposed to return the segregated values of zeros and ones. Okay, segregated values of zeros and ones means, so nothing but, so we should so separate zeros and ones, okay. We should keep zeros so in the starting position and ones into the last position. Okay, so that is nothing but segregation. Okay, so observe now. So code for this one. Okay, test cases are given now. Let us see these test cases now. Okay, so okay, so 10 is the size, and next to that, so these are values of array, guys. Observe output, guys, everyone. Void cannot return. Okay, so what it is given, ma? 1 minute, let me check. Do they given void? 1 minute, let me check. Void order. Okay, fine. I think so here problem is there with this code itself. Okay, no so convert that one into, so array, or else so don't think like this, okay. So observe this one. A return means here simply consider like this. Okay, here itself we should print id number d2, correct. Return means here, consider that we should print here itself. Okay, so it is not required to return anything. Okay, in this function itself we should print array values. Okay, after separating zeros and ones. Okay, observe code, ma, first of all. I think so you understood. So this test case here, so zeros and ones we should separate like this, guys. Zeros we should keep in the starting positions, ones in the ending position. Okay, so observe this next one, test case one. Input is 6, values are this one. Okay, and so what is this expected return value? So 6 ones. If we are having all so non-zero values, by the time we should return so this one, but the inputs are not matching. Let us see code at once. Think so few mistakes were there in this one. Let us see code. Okay, with the help of this code, let us try to understand. So array and length is taken, I variable for so traversing. Okay, okay, array of I, if array of I double is equals to 0, okay, we are incrementing so count by 1. Okay, afterwards with the help of this for loop, we are traversing, and so we are assigning 0. Okay, and outside of this we are taking one more for loop, so we are starting traversing from count. Okay, so from count to 2, so last position, so we are traversing and we are assigning 1 here. Okay, that's very good. ID number 478, count to declaration. See, observe one thing, ma, here. So count is incremented by 1 here, but count is not declared. Okay, so count should be declared and initialized to 0, right? So then only we can apply increment all this. Okay, so count is equals to 0. Okay, that's good. Int count is equals to 0. Good. Next, apart from this, any more errors, ma? N, very good. This one, so here n is not there, right? In place of n we are having length. Okay, ma, we should use this one. N is not there. Okay, in place of n we should use the length here. Okay, This is simple program. I think so you all know this program, segregating so zeros and ones, okay, keeping all so zero values in so starting position and keeping all ones in the ending positions. So this is nothing but segregation program, okay. We should make two corrections, okay, so onto this one to get executed, guys. Yes, observe changes, my everyone. Yes, two changes only. Count is equals to zero, length and semicolon. Okay, fine. Observe, my one more mistake is there here. Are you observing this one? Colon. Yes. That's why you should observe carefully, ma. Okay, each and everything observe here. After correcting, still if you get any errors, so go through again, ma. Once again, okay. Comma also. Where comma, ma? Okay, fine. Here also one more error is there. Comma. Ma, here we should take so semicolon, and here also we should take semicolon, guys. Okay. See, in for loop of I, we are having two more mistakes, ma. So semicolons. Okay. That's good, ma. Good. Correct. So totally four errors are there in this one. Okay. I updated only three, I think so. So here I directly taken so semicolon, but I didn't highlighted this. Okay. So here you can observe this corrected code. There is no error in this one. Okay. But I didn't highlighted this one. That's it. Okay. So this semicolon part I didn't highlighted. Okay. So but here we should correct this one also, guys. Okay. We corrected that one also. Semicolon. Totally four errors we corrected. Okay. So in that one. Next. Good. Read the next so programmer. Next one is code, I think so. Okay. So observe once, my everyone. The function void array sort is used to sort array, and the sorted array is given as input to the next function, okay, to calculate median. But to calculate median, so this sorted array output is given as input to the another function, okay, as good. The function float median, so accepts array and so n value, okay, that is length, okay. Array is the array to store values, and n is the size of the array. Okay, the logic for the above function is given. Some of its parts are missing. Your task is to fill the missing part of the code. Okay, means we should write code, guys, now. Okay, observe. What is the code required? So observe, everyone, guys. Observe these test cases. First of all, input size is 5. Values are 32146. Okay, expected return value is 3.00. How we get this one, ma? Add these values, everyone. 6 + 4 = 10, 11, 13, 16. So 16 divided by, yes, ma, after sorting. So after dividing this one, so we want to find median value, right? Okay, so not average value, median. Median value 3.00. 3.00 means so float. Okay, let us return in the form of float. Okay, now let us take so next one. Input is 8, so values are these 1, 3, 5, 2, 9, 12, 21. 1, 2, 3, 5, and so 9. After applying sorting, you'll get like this 12, 21, 34, 1, 2, 3, 5, 9, 12, 21, 34. Okay, so you'll get so this max value, guys. Okay, so this one we should return this one, not 5 more. Okay, so totally 8 values are there in this one. So in these 8 values, you should return fourth position value. Okay, So that is the code. Okay, good. Now let us see. So programmer. Already, so array sorted program is given, guys. Okay, sort program is given. Observe this one. So this is, what is this sorting, ma? Can you tell me this one? Bubble sort, very good. Ma, are you observing this one? Array of j greater than array of j plus 1. Each and every time I value and j value is starting from zero position. Very good, ma. So here few members given, so correct answer. Bubble sort. Each and every time I and j is starting from zero, j is comparing with j plus 1. So, and so this one, n is decrementing by 1 here. Okay, that's good. Actually, we need one more thing here. Okay, so that is n minus I minus 1. That was missed here. Okay, but corrections, all these are not required. They will give you correct code only. Okay, so but here by the time of so typing and pasting all this, at that time, things so few things missed. Okay, so no problem. So this is bubble sort program. See here, we should write code, ma. So float value is the return. Okay, yes, simply we can easily complete this one, right? Okay, ma, leave it, leave about so that sorting program, focus on this one, ma, median. Okay, so actually if we got array and n as input, right? Okay, now what we should return actually here, so we should return so middle value, right? Ma, listen, ma, for loop of I, low plus I divided by 2, all these are not required. So simply return this one, array of this one, n divided by 2. N divided by 2 means nothing but middle position value, right? Okay, so return this one, return array of n divided by 2. You will get these type of things only, ma. Okay, ma, listen, simply within one or two lines you can easily complete it, ma. Okay, ma, listen, listen, wait 1 minute, let us check. So if it is 8, ma, it is not required. So to check for even length and odd length, 8 divided by 2 means what you'll get? So 4. Okay, so let us take this one. So 5 divided by 2. So what you'll get? So 2, second position. So there is no problem in it, ma. Okay, so you won't get any problem here. Yes, ma, very good. ID number G7. So we should return so float value, right? So here, yes, ma, very good. Deepika, sir, the code which we should find errors or write the code is in C language always. Yes, ma. I think so. I didn't understood your so doubt correctly, ma. For which we should find errors? But they'll give you so in problem statement clearly. So they'll give you like this, write missing code. So by that time, go for writing code. So if they don't give you like this, go for making corrections. That's it. Okay, so if they ask you, so write in C language only, ma. You'll be not having Python language, ma. Okay, I don't know about this year. So if they introduce you Python, there is no problem in it. Okay, if they don't, actually we are observing so C language, C++, Java only. Okay, so in this regarding this drive and CTS and all these, okay, if they included Python, it is better for you people. Okay, so but that's why you should have knowledge on all these languages, guys, not only Python. Okay, should have knowledge on C, Java, all these required. So fine, simple, we can easily finish it, right? One line code, ma, within one line, so we can finish this. Okay, yes. Next one, so reverse. So we already completed this one, right? Void reverse, reversing the entire array. Okay, so again in so another one also we are observing this one. That's it. Okay, observe.
what is this actually? 1 minute more. This is different reverse program, I think so. So not same one. 1 minute, let me check. Let us read this one more. Function void reverse accepts array starting position and ending position, performs the reverse operation on array within the specified intervals of start and end. Okay, find the missing lines code. Okay, fine, understood. I hope so everyone understood this one. But this is not normal reverse. So actually here, so we get different types of so start values and end values. For those start and end values, we should reverse. Ma, 6 is the size, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 values, 2 and 4. In between 2 and 4 positions, we should shuffle. Ma, okay? Means observe. We are shuffling from so second to fourth position here. So only these positions. So next of all, next test case is 10. Okay? So these are values. Ma. So 5 and 9. So 5 means 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Means from this position onwards, okay? 5 to 9 means up to the ending, I think so. Yes. Up to the ending, we should change, guys, okay? All these values we should change. We already discussed this one, right? So if you want, I will explain this. But do you want code for this one? Reverse for specified intervals. Okay, ma. Do you want code for this one? I'm asking. But between start and end. Okay, one member, few members are asking. Okay, 1 minute. So let me explain, ma. Just I will take few minutes. Okay. Then few minutes I'll explain it. Int n. I scanf. So first of all, input size, okay. Next of all, declaring array, okay. Afterwards, taking inputs as so beginning and next to that ending values, guys, okay. Ampersand start and ampersand end, okay. Observe, guys, everyone. What you should do, you should take some temporary variable, okay, for so swapping here. Observe everyone without so taking some function directly. I will take it, okay? Or else if you want that one, I will take so this one reverse. So what you should pass array start and end values, right? Okay, so now we should take temporary variable. So in that part, void reverse, okay, int pointer array, int start, int end. Okay, that's good. Ma, observe here. So let us take some temporary variable for swapping. So until we are going to reach to the middle position, we should keep on swaps, okay, starting and ending position values. That's it, ma. While s less than or is equals to e, okay. So starting value until reaching to this ending value, guys. Whenever s value crosses ending value, or else s value reaches to this ending value, so till by that time we should swap it, okay. So array of so s, okay, array of s is equals to array of n, array of n is equals to temp, okay. And so finally we should increment start value by 1. And so we should decrement end value by 1. Okay. See, earlier in the previous classes, I explained reverse program in another way with the help of for loop. Okay. The reason is we should take in that format only, means we should correct errors. So in that format code. Okay. So now here, so for us, choice is given, right? Okay. So we should write code now. Okay. If you want to write code, you can simply finish ma like this. Okay. So this is the easiest methodology. So with this one, you can easily finish, guys. Okay, that's good. I hope so everyone understood this one. So next of all, we should print this one, right? Observe. So for I is equals to 0, I less than array of length is not possible, right?
or else let us do one thing now. Let us print in this one, okay? So in main function itself. I think so, we didn't take in values for array, right? For I is equals to 0, I less than n, I plus plus, okay? Scanf percentile d ampersand of a of I, okay? Let us copy and paste this one, guys. So instead of scanf, use this one, guys, okay? Printf. Instead of ampersand, just here, okay? Abzoma. Okay, S and E are not declared. Okay, fine. Abza output everyone now. Let us execute the first one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 values we taken, right? Okay. So in this one, so we need to interchange the second and fourth position values, right? Abza output my everyone. My second and fourth. See, the same program you observed for number of times now. Reversing array you observed, okay? Reversing half of the array you observed. So now you are observing reversing array, so with some particular interval values, okay? So this one is important for these CTS and next to that for DXC, these type of automated drives. So these type of coding questions are important, guys, okay? So I think so you can easily finish it off, okay?
Sir, can we write code in C++ or Java? Like in C++, we have inbuilt swap function, no? In
yes,
Java also
write.
We have inbuilt functions.
You can write one, no problem. So you can write so program in C++, Java also, no problem. Here I am showing, so actually most of the students don't know about C++ and Java, right? Okay, so that's why here I am, okay, I will paste that code in the chat box. Right. So have this one more. See, actually, most of the students don't know about this C++ and Java, right? So that's why I'm explaining here. So actually, you are facing difficulty with C language also here. So with pointers, double pointers, and all this. Again, in that, actually, C++ and Java, so few more topics are there. So which you don't know might be. So that's why here I'm explaining with CMO, okay? That's good. I hope so everyone understood this. Simple mark. If they ask you reverse, so just to make use of this one. With this, you can simply finish it, okay? That's good. Next one. Next program. Next one is also program only, I think so. That is the last program, I think so. Read the problem statement, ma. I think so. Next one is the last one. Ma, we already discussed this calculate matrix sum, right? Okay. So we eradicated errors in this one. Okay. Yes, ma. Java won't support pointers. Okay. So objects itself acts as pointers. Ma, okay. Ma, see, observe. So next to this, we are having matrix sum. Ma. We already discussed this matrix sum program. Okay. So that's why I am moving to this one. Ma, okay. So just on finishing this program. So we are going to finish so these programs, guys. Ma, listen, observe carefully, ma. Ma, here we should get output like this, ma. Okay, expected output, but we are getting output like this, ma. 0, 0, 0. Ma, modify the code, ma. Make it first. Still, after completion of this code, we should observe one more code. Okay, so that too, that is coding question, ma. We are left over with one more thing. Ma, we are not getting correct output, okay? So check this one. Where errors are present. So a value is 10, index value is 0, array is declared with 10 size, remainder variable is taken. So until a value becomes 0, so we are applying modulus division of operation with 2. And that remainder value we are storing in this certain index position. We are incrementing this, okay? And next of all, so here what you'll get for this 10. So just now only we observed this program, ma. Ma, decimal to binary program. I just now I explained 10 modulus division of 2. So for this one, you'll get like this, okay? So 0, that 0 value will be taken here. Index value will be incremented. Yes, a divided by 2. So this is missing, right? Ma, this is a decimal to binary conversion program. Decimal to binary conversion, but this one is missing. We should include this one, right? Okay, very good. But not a divided by 10. A is equals to a divided by 2. Ma, a is equals to a divided by 2. Just now only I explained. By the time of explaining, so this one converting the binary to decimal, I explained decimal to binary also for this purpose only. Ma, now answer it. So now all these values will be stored into this array. So we are printing that. So with the help of so this for loop here, guys. So apart from this, any more changes? Ma, let us see corrected code now at once. See, we should take reverse for loop, ma, here. One more change is there. Observe this for loop, ma. Actually, we get values like this, right? So on applying 10 modulus division 2, you'll get 0. In 0th memory location, you'll get 0. In the first memory location, you'll get 1. In the second memory location, you'll get 0. In the third memory location, you'll get 1, guys. Okay, so what you should print output, we should print output like this, right? 1010 means we should traverse in the reverse direction, guys. Okay, means we should reverse this for loop here. This for loop is not correct, ma. Ma, we should include this one. A is equals to, so a divided by 2. Afterwards, so we should reverse this one, ma, for loop of I. Okay, these two changes we should made. So for this program, guys, okay, a is equals to a divided by 2. Okay, I is equals to index minus 1, I greater than or is equals to 0, I minus minus. Okay, simply we are observing a conversion program of this one, a decimal to binary with arrays, ma. Okay, with arrays we are observing converting decimal program to binary here. Okay, yes, that's it. So here this one we discussed, okay, a matrix sum. You all eradicated error also for this one, okay? So that is here error is there, I told you. If I is equals to j and next to that matrix of ij, modulus division of 2, okay, then only we should go for adding. And here also one change is there, matrix of ij. Okay, we should make corrections here and here, guys. Okay, so these type of changes we already discussed, right? We discussed this program already. Okay, it's good. Observe the changes, ma. So here we should make corrections, okay, regarding this. Okay, ma, that's it. These are these type of coding questions, ma, okay? So automatic coding questions you will get in the drive, guys. Okay, most probably we discuss your coding questions, right? In the same coding questions, the same coding questions are repeating, ma, every year. Okay, so they are not changing these coding questions. Okay, matrix program. Okay, ma, definitely. But this is a matrix program. One minute, I will share it. We discussed this program, right? No, ma, there is no limit so for executing and all this, okay? You can execute for any number of times, but you should execute finally. That is required. There is no limit for execution and all these. Okay. Okay, fine. Listen, ma. You will get these type of automated coding questions, ma. Listen. So for some coding questions, you should correct, ma, errors. Okay. And for some coding questions, you should write code, guys. Simply, only these two things you should follow. Okay. For this one And sometimes you should make use of the code, whatever already given to us. Okay. Some of the code will be given, guys, for us. We should make use that. By making use of that, we should complete the remaining code. So these type of things you should do, guys. Within 20 minutes, you should complete 7 more. Okay. Ma, listen, ID number A not. So you won't get any error, Ma. So if you include windows.h header file, section wise time limit. Yes, Ma. Section wise time limit will be there. ID number A3. Yes, Ma. Definitely. So 15 MCQs already it is given in the Discord, right? Okay. So 15 MCQs. So you should complete within 12 minutes. So these 7 automata coding questions you should complete within 20 minutes. So time limit will be there, Ma, for each and every section. Okay. You think so? You can easily finish it off, Ma. So technical now, because we discussed automata, right? You will get the same thing. Okay. In the drives also, you'll get the same coding questions. You can easily finish it off. Okay. So, and next to that, concentrate on the remaining rounds also, Ma. Okay. So verbal, quant, all this. Okay. Concentrate on that one also. Okay. Ma, definitely you'll get no problem, Ma. In that drive, you'll get function will be executed, Ma. ID number A not. You won't get any problem. Use that one. Difference time of ending time and starting time. It will be executed. You won't get any problem, Ma.